Hello guys, welcome back to my channel, and in today's video I'll be sharing my favorites for the month of August. I have been off from YouTube for quite some time, so I just thought of casually having a video and showcasing the products at least rather than missing from YouTube. So yes, this is the video and you can definitely watch this video because I have a few repurchased items, I have a few favorites and I have a new products and some misses as well. So I have just put it all together in this video and I hope you enjoy this video. So yeah, let's begin with today's video. So the first and foremost thing which I wanted to mention is the hair care products. So I have been using this Wella Invigio Nutri Rich with Goji Berry Deep Nourishing Shampoo. This is a sulfate based shampoo. It does have sodium lauryl sulfate and sodium lauryl sulfate, but the smell of this shampoo is so nice, and also it is so moisturizing. I really like this shampoo. Though this is not a new launch, I just thought of sharing this product with you because this is a really a good shampoo if you are looking out for something for frizzy hair and oily scalp. I think this is a good one. This comes at a price of 680 rupees. However, you might find some discount online. So I will link all the products in the description box below for your reference. And yeah, this is with a very, very nice fragrance, which I feel is very, very soothing. And it has a very luxurious smell to it, which I absolutely love. And I also like how it works on the hair. It just gives a very silky finish to the hair and it also cleans the scalp pretty well. So I was really impressed with this shampoo. So yeah, this was the favorite product for the month of August. Coming to the conditioner, I did try out the Plums Coconut Milk and Peptide Strength and Shine Conditioner. This is a new launch and I absolutely fell in love with the conditioner. The only con of this conditioner is the smell, which is a bit coconut and old school kind of smell. It comes at a price of 375 and I have also shot a full-fledged video on this Plums new range, so you can obviously watch that. To the moisturizer, I have repurchased the Atomist cream. This is the second tube and that tube lasted for almost more than six months, and I am definitely in love with this one. I love the way it moisturizes my skin. Even though I have a very acne prone skin, it never ever have given me any breakouts. Moreover, it tries to calm down if I have any inflammation. So I do tend to use a lot of like ceramide based moisturizer on my inflammation. If I get a few, I do tend to apply it on it, and it doesn't, like, it is not a pore clogging moisturizer. So definitely I get a lot of question on this Atomist cream, and I just wanted to clarify that you can definitely try this if you have combination or dry skin and normal skin as well. So this is a really good one, and if you feel like it is thick, you can just spray Avene spray or even your toner and then applied. It is the Round Lab Docto toner. So actually I got the smaller bottle from a Purple, and this was priced at something around 300 or 400 or something, I don't remember, but I don't even have a little bit of the product left because I really love this product. I emptied this product and I think it's great for all skin types. It is great for oily skin as well. It is not thick, but it does have a very cooling and soothing effect. Hydrates the skin, which is pretty good. I definitely recommend this, and I was about to place the order for the second bottle, the big bottle, but by mistake I ordered the lotion instead of the toner, and now I am stuck with this lotion because they don't like take the return for obviously it was my mistake that I placed a wrong order, so they didn't return it. So I am now in a state where I don't know what to do with the product. And there's an update on this Glow Serum Propolis and Niacinamide. I did tell that this one is quite hydrating, but it did break me out at some instances, so I stopped using this. I feel like it is more effective during the winter months, so I will be using this during the winter months rather than the summer months. So this was very hydrating, and I feel like my skin was not able to take this much of hydration, so I stopped using this. But yeah, this is a good one, but just I wanted to update because I did tell so much about this in my last video, in one of my older videos. Ghar Soaps Ayurvedic Science, this eye patches. Now I really wanted to try the eye patches from this company DU. Those were pretty expensive. Finally, this one I got from Ghar Soaps, and this is quite affordable. And this is a nice one. You can just apply your eye cream and then apply this eye patch across your under eye area. And this is a really, really good one to moisturize your under eyes for a longer amount of time. I did use this around 3 times and I am pretty impressed, so you can definitely go for this one. For now, I have produced a lot of videos on azelaic acid on my channel and I do get a lot of questions on azelaic acid. Now, if you're looking out for an effective azelaic acid from an Indian brand, I do know like Paula's Choice does have azelaic acid, which comes at quite an expensive price. Now, if you're looking out from Indian brand, you can definitely try this Cure Skin Azelaic Acid Cream 15%. I have been using this for more than a month now and I am truly impressed with this. Like, I had a few breakouts last month and it did like dry it up completely, and I want to say like this is not drying like the other azelaic acid which I have tried. This is quite moisturizing. I mean it is quite contradictory, but it is quite moisturizing, unlike the other azelaic acids which are available in Indian pharmacy and in the Indian market. So you can definitely try this. If they have an app, Cure Skin app, you can download that and you can get it from there. Now, this is priced at 375, which is affordable, and this also lasts for quite some time. This is 15 gram, but it like the cream consistency is quite like creamy and it spreads over a larger surface area, so you get maximum usage out of this. Now, you're not supposed to use this every day. You are supposed to use around 3 to 4 days in a week. You can give a day's gap in between the usages and then you can definitely use this. This is my favorite, like one of the favorite azelaic acid which I could find in the Indian market. I will definitely recommend this to all of you. Facial razor for women. I repurchased this one from Carmacy. I did like Carmacy's face razor quite well and I just repurchased because this was one of the lowest priced one, and I feel like because a face razor is supposed to be used like twice or thrice or maximum 4 times, so I just thought like I would go for the cheapest one because anyways I would have to throw this out subsequently. So yeah, I got this 1% hyaluronic tinted sunscreen gel. I have been using this for more than a month now and it is really good. I will definitely repurchase this one. It didn't give me any breakouts, which is why I'm recommending it again and again. So I did mention about it in my one of my videos on mineral sunscreens, and yeah, I definitely like this one. This is tinted, gives you coverage, a little bit of coverage here and there, and not full coverage obviously, and it does protect you from visible light and both UVA and UVB because it has PA4 plus and SPF 60, so which is great. And yeah, I do like this. This is really a very good like moisturizer. I have got to know why my family uses this one. Like in Kolkata, everyone uses Nivea body milk and I used to stick to Vaseline and Pond's, but this one is really good. It doesn't give that chip effect and also moisturizes your skin for a longer amount of time. I really like this body lotion. Now I have one more product. Now the last product which I have with me is the Nivea Pearl and Beauty deodorant. Now this is the one which I emptied. Now prior to this I had used Chemist at Play this one deodorant, and it was great. It was soothing. It also helped me to get rid of the dark marks a lot, but I didn't want to overuse exfoliating acids on my underarm for a longer period of time. That's why I got this. Now this is great. Now thinking that this is great, I repurchased and I got a different one in the category like with natural glow smooth skin, but I feel like this one does like dry out my skin a lot. I am just noticing it nowadays, so I don't know, like I don't have an opinion. I think this is great. This didn't at least dry out my skin, but this one does, so I am looking out for a good like exfoliating free body deodorant because I don't want to exfoliate my underarm so much so that I end up with some like imbalanced skin barrier. So yes, I do want to go for a normal one. If you have any suggestions, you can leave that in the comment section below. So yes, those are all the products which I used. I'll be coming up with more such products. I have a lot of products. I will soon be publishing all of those. So yes, that was all about this video, and I hope you found this video useful. If you have stayed until this point, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel and also like this video. I will see you soon in my next video. Till then, bye bye and take care.